guys, welcome to my channel. So finally, I have it all here, and it is Hiba Halal Aloe Aqua Combo. My friend Shaima from the Desert Rose Jungles raved about these products. She was so happy with them, like it made me buy these things and try it out myself. And by the way, she has a YouTube channel herself. You can go and check that out. It's in the bottom bar below. And when she says something is really good, it has to be good. So I just went ahead and bought this combo. She also talked about the Hiba Halal Pro Skin Foundation and said that it's kind of a staple for her right now, kind of holy grail product for her. So I did not buy that because my skin is tan and I'm not sure what shade I need to buy. So I have to still figure out that. But I am a skincare freak, you guys know it. I love my skin to be flawless. I love my skin to be perfect. Like if I have perfect skin, I can skip the makeup. I just need my skin to be so good. So she raved about these products and she raved about them so much that I went ahead and bought them myself. So it is a combo of 5 things. The first thing is the Hiba Halal Care Aloe Aqua Refreshing Spray, and this is how it looks like. Next thing is this Hiba Halal Care Aloe Aqua Face and Body Gel, and this is how it looks like. The next thing up is this Hiba Halal Care. I'm saying that Hiba Halal Care every time because it's from Hiba. Like, why did I have to say that? The next thing is their Face Wash Plus Makeup Remover, and this is how it looks like. In fact, these two bottles look very similar, and the first day, like, it's really funny. The first day when I got this, I was just placing things everywhere, wherever I'll be using those things. So I placed the face and body gel on my wash basin and the face wash and makeup remover on my dressing table. And I washed my face with the face and body gel and then applied this on my face. Like, can you believe that? And then when I was applying this, I realized that it's foaming. And when I was applying this, it did not foam. I thought, maybe, yeah, it's nice. It's not foaming. It's not a foam-based cleanser. So I was really happy about that. But then actually it turned out to be a face and body gel. It turned out to be a face wash. My bad, I know that. The next, I really wish if they could just change a bit of the packaging because they are bit of their packaging because they are so similar. Can you make a difference? No. Okay. So the next thing up is this Hiba Halal is their Aloe Aqua No Blemish Cream, and this is how it looks like. And the last thing in the combo is their body lotion, and this is how it looks like. It's a tiny bottle of 80 ml. But yeah, it's very travel friendly, it's really small, and I think it's really nice to carry it in your purse. So yeah, I'm not gonna review these products, but I'm just gonna tell you about my first impression kind of a review, like what I personally feel about these things. I've used them twice or thrice, so which is not quite enough, to review them. But yeah, they are quite enough to give you a first impression of mine. So let's start off with, I'll start off with two things which I think has multi-use. So I'll talk about the refreshing face spray and the face and body gel. All the products I've read the contents have glycerin in it, and they have quite an amount of glycerin. So they have aloe vera, they have cucumber, they have glycerin, and all three of these things are really good for your skin. They helps in giving hydration to your skin, moisturizing your skin. And if you have really dry skin, glycerin will really help you out to get over it. So my skin actually became really dry around these areas. Like, it's really sweaty and oily on the T-zone, but around these areas, like especially these patches, the cheeks, it becomes really, really dry to the extent that it starts burning and sometimes even shows off. Like, it becomes flaky in summer also. So I used this face spray first. It's not like normal face spray. Don't relate it to like rose water or cucumber water. It's a bit sticky. So when you spray it, you feel that okay, 5 minutes it will be just okay. 10 minutes it will be okay. No, it won't be. It's kind of sticky thing. It's not like aloe vera gel either. Like, when you apply aloe vera gel, it seeps into your skin becomes matte. But when you apply this spray, your skin, when you apply this spray, your skin is not going to be matte. It will, on the other hand, will be a bit sticky, a bit tacky, which I think is good if you have dry skin, and it's not good if you have oily skin. So if you have oily skin, I'm not sure that you should use this, but if you have dry skin or normal skin, this will work so good for you. So I have those dry patches here, and when I applied this on my skin actually burned. And it's a good sign that it burned. Like, I'm not telling you it burned because it is bad, but my skin was so dry that the glycerin instantly acted on it and I got a burning sensation, which actually faded away after like 5 minutes or 10 minutes, but the skin was still tacky, and by the time you did not wash it, your skin will remain tacky, which means that it stays on your skin. So if you're going out, I'm not sure if you should use this because the dirt will stick onto your face. Those are just my opinion, because it is really really tacky, and when you go out there will be dust and it might just stick onto your skin. So I think you can go on for a moisturizer on top of it to make it a bit matte, because it is sticky. The next thing is this face and body gel, which is very runny. It's quite runny, it's flowy, so it's really difficult to get the exact product onto your hand. You might tend to get a bit more, and it's like, you can see, I don't know if you can see it or not, it is really runny. It's a green color liquid. I'm not sure about this. Just look about this. Okay, so this is also a green color fluid. It's a green color liquid, and it has the same concept, this one has the same impact as the spray. It's sticky, it remains onto your skin until you wash it off. Now, that was the first thing, like the first way of usage. It's a gel, it's a spray, just spray it on your skin and for the skin care. The second usage is, these are really 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 good primers because they're sticky and they have a really good amount of glycerin in it. Your makeup is not gonna go anywhere if you use these. Like any of these, both of these together is gonna act a really 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 amazing primer, with a really big thumbs up for them, because this one retails just for 95 rupees and this one retails for this retails for 99 rupees and this one is for 95 rupees. I think those are the most affordable makeup primers you can ever get. They are good for your skin, and at the same time they will act as a beautiful primer for your skin, make your skin really soft, really smooth for you to work it on it. And since they have a lot of amount of glycerin and aloe vera in it, your makeup is not going to go anywhere. Next, I'll move on to this blemish cream. Okay, it is a blemish cream, but I'm not reviewing it because I cannot still say that whether it works on your blemishes or not. But yeah, all of these products smell the same. They have a similar smell. You cannot actually make out which one is what, but because it is aloe aqua combo, they all smell the same. But this is how it looks like. It's a white color bottle, and it has a cap inside it as well, which is actually a bit difficult to open, at least for me. This is how it opens up, and it is a white color cream. It smells actually similar to the other products. It has a lemony, citrusy, cucumbery, aloe kind of smell. If that makes sense. Okay, so I have used it a couple of times as my night cream basically, and I'm quite happy with it. I have zits all over this cheek and they are quite suppressed now, and I'll still be using it for another 2 or 3 days to see if it clears out my skin perfectly or not. I have like a lot of zits on this side. It's probably because of the dirt and the wind with such a lot of dust in it. Then we have the Aloe Aqua Face Wash Plus Makeup Remover. I've not tried it as a makeup remover, but I've used it as a face wash. It is a really good face wash. Like, it just makes your skin feel so clean. All the dirt, all the gunk is just out of your skin. It makes your skin so, so, so clean. I really love it. It has aloe vera and cucumber in it, and it can be used as a face wash, as a makeup remover as well. It has a bit thicker consistency than that face gel, but yeah, it is also a green colored gel, and it has neem as well, so very good for your skin. I'm sure this one also. only this has neem in it, so I'm sure very good for your skin, will not give you any skin problems. Like 3-4 days I have no skin problems so far, so I think anybody won't, because even a face wash can cause me pimples. I really just throw away the face wash the moment I see a pimple on my face with a face wash. So this did not give me any pimple for 3 days. I'm really happy with this as well. The last thing is this body lotion, which I tried just once and I was quite happy because it did make my skin hydrated, did not dry it out throughout the day, so really love that as well. So those were the 5 products. I forgot to tell you about this thing. These are cruelty free, these are halal products, and these are wuzu friendly, which is actually cruelty free. And if you want to know a bit more detail about the brand itself, then go and check out Shaima's channel. She has actually told what everything means, because she's a Muslim, she basically understands all these things. I do not, but yeah, according to her, being a halal product and a wuzu friendly product is really a great thumbs up. Like, it's really good that something like this exists in India, according to her. I am not sure what those terms means, but yeah, if you're looking for something like halal product or something which is wuzu friendly, then you should certainly go for this these products. And if you're looking for something which is really good for your skin, for normal skin, for dry skin, I think these are really good products. But for oily skin, I am not too sure. For normal to dry skin, these will work, because I do have a combination skin and they're working just fine for me. So yeah, Eva Halal Care, a big thumbs up from my side. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you're looking for buying these, I got them from amazon.com. I got them from amazon.in. Everything is in a bottom bar as well for you guys to check out what all is in the combo and where you can find it. Everything is in the bottom bar. Just click that show more button and you can find everything. And yeah, that was all for today's video. If you guys enjoyed this and this review was really helpful, review/first impression was helpful to you, then do not forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and take care. I shall see you next time.